Hey girl, hey! Welcome and welcome back to Heavenly Zen Designs, where crafting and chaos meet. We mix media art, wood decor, life, and more. You just never know what we're getting into next. Go grab your coffee and pull up a seat. We got lots to do, people, lots to do, and even more to talk about. My name is Kelly, and I am so excited you're here. Hey, before we begin, please do me a solid and share this channel with all of our friends. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button and click the bell icon so you too can be the first to know when new videos are released. Well, hello, all you beautiful people. Welcome back. Today, we are going to be making what I call my chicken coop tiered tray. You guys, wow. So many steps to making this tiered tray, just as far as painting goes, and a bunch of times I thought I goofed. I'm not even gonna lie. With that being said, let's jump into this video and let me show you guys how I made my own chicken coop tiered tray. So to begin, I have all the pieces of my chicken coop laid out. And I'm going to be pulling out all of my basics acrylic paint in raw umber, burnt umber, titanium white, iridescent graphite, silver, neutral gray, and bronze. The first thing I'm going to do is mix my raw and burnt umbers together. Next, I'm going to paint each piece with two coats of paint, drying and then flipping them over and repeating the process on the other side. Now, initially, I had thought that I wanted just a hint of white on here, and I was going to do that by dry brushing it. However, the little amount of white that I was putting on here was not speaking to me. It was too brown in the background, and I don't know if you guys have figured this out yet, but I prefer gray tones over brown tones. But I just decided just roll with it and let's see where this goes. And if I wasn't happy with the end result, then I'll just make a new end result and repaint the entire thing. Next, I'm going to tape off my chicken wire and I'm going to pull out my iridescent graphite and I'm going to paint the chicken wire areas on both sides. I really want my chicken wire to look metal, old, rusty. And in order to do that, I end up painting it several different colors. And I will give you guys really good up close and personal pictures at the end. Okay, so now I realize that I've made quite a mess on my silicone mat, and to stand here and try to get all that paint off when I'm in the middle of the project is probably not gonna happen. Let's just be honest. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put masking tape on this side, and then I'm going to sponge my different colors, my neutral grays, my graphite, my silvers, and the bronze. I'm gonna stamp them all over to get that old metal look that I'm looking for. All right, so the next thing I'm gonna do is peel the tape off of this side, and then I'm going to grab my black Posca marker and I'm going to go around the very edge of where the wire is at, because I want to give the wire contrast and a shadow so that it looks like it's set in to the wood, you know, how wood would be built around wire. So I want to give it that look that it's set in, and the way that you can achieve that is with graphite pencil, charcoal pencil, Posca pen, paint even can do it. So now we're going to do this same exact thing we did on this side. On the other side, I'm going to take my masking tape off of the other side and put it on the side I just finished, and then redo the whole process. I'm going to go in with my sponge and I'm going to sponge on the neutral grays, the silvers, and the bronze. Then I'm going to take my Posca pen and I'm going to make that shadow or contour where my wire ends and where the wood begins. Before I start gluing this together, I want you guys to see that I did continue to distress this and I made it even more white. More white, less brown. I was actually much happier with the more white aspect of it. For some reason, I just can't get with the static look. So I chose to just continue to add white until I was happy with it. You still can see the brown underneath, and I will go in here in a minute and start basically chipping at it, I guess you could say. But before that, we are going to finish gluing this together. Okay, guys, so most of this is glued together except for the little front pieces that I still have to do, but I wanted to show you again what I was talking about, that static look, like what's on old TVs. Now, I know you young whippersnappers won't have a clue what I'm talking about. However, if you're my age or older, you know exactly what I'm talking about. That three-channel situation, and when the president was on, your night was shot. Any Jeff Foxworthy fans in here? The president's on! He's on every channel! We're gonna miss Flipper! Anybody? No? Just me? That's okay. All right, you guys. So I am distressing it with more white paint. I really wanted this to look old. So I was going in there with different tools and nicking it up and rubbing on the edges of all the little cutouts. But at the same time, not touching my chicken wire. And I actually like it way better with it even more distressed. So as you can see, I'm in here with my little Cricut scraper tool. I don't even know what kind of tool this is, you guys. Man, if you guys knew how new I am to the crafting world, you'd be like, what? So anyways, I'm in there and I'm nicking and I'm scratching and I'm doing all different kinds of stuff. I'm doing other things to this because I literally want this to look like this was your great grandmother's chicken coop that you have repurposed as a tiered tray. So like I said, I'm going in here and I am distressing these pieces even more. Those skinny pieces actually go in front of each of the shelves to keep whatever you are putting on there from falling off. So I'm just going to distress them to my liking, and I am just going around the chicken coop and continuing to distress it until I get it to a distressed look that I'm looking for. And y'all, I am pretty sure I did it. I absolutely love how this turned out. Well, that is it, you guys. What do you think? Can you believe how it turned out? When I think about this and I think about how it was like that dark brown color, it would have clashed with my chicken wire. It would have clashed. It wouldn't have looked good. But then I didn't like the static either. So speaking of chicken wire, y'all, pictures does not do my chicken wire justice. It is gorgeous. Gorgeous in person. Stunning. So how do you like my farmhouse chicken coop tiered tray? Would you have done anything different? Let me know down below. I hope you all enjoyed today's video. As always, thank you so much for being here. If you have any questions about the process or where I get my supplies and it's not already in the description box, just leave a comment and I'll get back to you. Again, please do me a solid and share this channel. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and click the bell icon if you haven't done so already, so you too can be the first to know when new videos are released. Until next time, my friends, craft like crazy, reign in the chaos, live life to the fullest, and I'll meet you right back here in my next video. Love you guys. Follow me on YouTube, Instagram, and TikTok at Heavenly Zen Designs, or visit my business page at www.heavenlyzendesigns.com.